The Jewish community here in New York is fed up by what they call disproportionate targeting by state and local officials. This has led to claims that their communities are responsible for the spread of the coronavirus, a message that they say is not only untrue, but dangerous.
People have to wear their masks. People have to social distance. And sometimes a summons is given because it needs to be. But we have to be careful not to overreach.
But that's exactly what folks here feel the government is doing. And they're using social media to show what's happening.
Because we have a list.
A list of what? You have a list of schools that are open?
Yes.
So you have a summons that you're writing before even coming into the school? Because you just came into the school. There's not one kid here.
That inspector and many others, those roaming around my district, have been sent to my district with a list on a mission.
Assemblyman Simca Eikenstein represents several neighborhoods in what's known as the Red Zone. That's how Governor Andrew Cuomo is classifying a high infection area. And the city is sending in officials to ensure their schools, houses of worship, and businesses are closed.
It's clear what has happened here. They've pulled inspectors from the buildings department, HPD, you name it, any agency you could think of that has inspectors, basically said, you're off your regular beat. You're going to Borough Park or you're going to Midwood and you're going to harass these Jewish stores.
There's nobody sitting in the restaurant. Everything is okay. You're giving me a ticket because my doors are open.
In this video, an inspector cites restaurant owner Jacob Green for just having the doors open and therefore, quote, violating a dining ban. Green's restaurant is limited to offering takeout, and he says he was simply letting air in on a hot day. A city councilman was able to have this summons rescinded.
I've had people reach out to my office. Some takeout place came up. They showed me the summons. Reason for the summons, violating the governor's executive order. Like, no further definition, what, when, how. I mean, they haven't gotten the basic training.
Eikenstein says the religious community began losing trust in the government after restrictions kept houses of worship closed until phase four of reopening.
To religious people, their houses of worship are essential. Within in the Jewish religion, and the Orthodox Jews go to synagogue three times a day to pray. Their entire way of life is around the house of worship. For houses of worship to be placed in phase four? How offensive.
Now, Eikenstein says Jewish neighborhoods are being singled out and shut down.
Driving from one end of the zip of the red zone to the other end of the red zone in Brooklyn could take you 45 minutes. The governor has used the term, we can now identify the virus block by block. Great. So release the positivity number block by block or show block by block where the improvement is.
The dialogue needs to continue. It can't be just enforcement without conversations.
Anti-Semitism advocate Devorah Halberstam is concerned about what she sees and hears coming from the top. Both Cuomo and Mayor Bill de Blasio have cited large Orthodox gatherings when asking New Yorkers not to gather en masse.
It's ridiculous to take one particular wedding and to just put it out there like that means that everybody is not following the rules. You can do that with each and every community. But in this particular instance, it's being done with the Jewish community, and I think it just needs to be stopped.
Halberstam knows firsthand what can result from public shaming like that.
My son was murdered. He was in a van with 15 students, kids, all kids. And the van was shot up with over 40 rounds of ammunition. They were Jews in that van, and that's what we was looking for. That is what happens when anti-Semitism has gone unchecked.
Halberstam recently wrote in the New York Daily News that the Jewish community doesn't have the luxury of waiting for the next attack based on hateful stereotypes. Anti-Semitism and instances of violence against Jews hit an all-time high in the U.S. before the pandemic began.
Anti-Semitism goes back for centuries. This is not a new thing, which is why we have to be very responsible.
To roll this out as an Orthodox Jewish problem, first of all, is factually incorrect, not backed up by the state data, but it is also divisive. and it will cause a rise in anti-Semitism.
A fact mentioned often by health officials is that COVID-19 does not discriminate. It's people who do that. Caitlin Burke, CBN News, Brooklyn.